welcome to Smart Learning Academy. Myself, Madhushri Datta, and I'm educator of SLA. Since you all know that we run the free crash courses on various life science exams, we have just not stopped on it. We are bringing the molecular tools and the technique lessons absolutely free of cost on our YouTube platform. And to your information, we are also starting the GATE crash courses that would be taken by me and the other top educators. So if you're preparing for GATE, do join us and make your dreams come into reality, as sir says. Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Learning Academy. Myself Madhushri Datta, and today we'll be starting with the third lesson on the molecular diagnostic techniques. It would be on the blotting hacks. So before going further into the detail, let me give you all a brief idea about myself. I have been a rank holder in my bachelor's and I have pursued my degree in the botany with a specialization in the plant physiology, biochemistry and the molecular biology. And I have been recruited as a research fellow for my PhD in the CSIR IHBT based in the Palampur. I have been a former project fellow in Banaras Hindu University, and these are the few national exams that I have qualified. So it comes into our mind, what is blotting? So blotting is a technique that has been divided into the three major steps. First is the resolution of a macromolecule such as the DNA, RNA and the protein onto the gel matrix after its treatment. Second is the transfer of such macromolecule from the gel strip onto a specialized chemically reactive matrix known as blotting membrane. It could be nitrocellulose or a nylon membrane. And the third step is the immobilization followed by the hybridization with a specific probe, and such probe could be radio labeled and unradio labeled. So therefore, it is being recognized as a powerful tool that not only helps in identifying, but it also does in the characterization of any specific molecule from a complex of molecules. Now let's come into the blotting types. The first is the Southern. It helps to identify and detect the DNA. The second is Northern, that is used to detect the RNA. The third is Western, that helps detect the protein. And the fourth is Eastern, that helps detect the post-transitional modified proteins. Now let's move into the types of blotting one by one. Since you can see in this slide, I have simply divided the Southern blotting into the eight major steps. First, what we are doing, we are extracting and purifying the DNA from the cells. Then we are digesting that DNA with the restriction enzymes. On the third step, we are separating such digested DNA by the gel electrophoresis. On the fourth step, we are denaturing the DNA. And then we are transferring the DNA from the gel onto the nitrocellulose paper. And then we are carrying out the hybridization process with the help of radio-labeled probe. And then we are washing off the unbound probe that has not been bound to the target. And on the eighth step, we are carrying out the autoradiography. Now let's move into the Northern blotting. Northern blotting is carried out in the similar way as compared to the Southern blotting. The only difference is what is the sample, that is the RNA. Now let's move on to the Western blotting. The Western blotting procedure in this slide, as you can see, I have simply divided into the six steps. So first, what we are seeing? We are seeing that we are loading and separating the such proteins onto the SDS page. Then we are doing the electrophoretic transfer of the fraction protein onto the PVDF membrane. Then we are blocking the membrane with the BSA and the milk casein. Then we are incubating the membrane with a primary antibody that would be specific to the target. And then we are incubating the membrane again with the HRP labeled secondary antibody specific to the primary antibody based upon its Fc region of the antibody. And then we are incubating the blot with a chemiluminescent HRP substrate to note down its reading based upon the autoradiography. Now let's come into the most important slide of today's lecture. This slide would simply help us to analyze the types of blotting in a shortest burst of time. It will summarize whatever we have read in today's lecture. So the molecule that is being used in case of separating in Southern is DNA, in case of Northern it is RNA, in case of Western it is protein. the gel leptophoresis. In case of southern, we are doing the agarose. In case of northern, we are doing the denaturing formaldehyde agarose. We are using the formaldehyde in order to prevent the hydrogen bonding between the complementary mRNAs. In case of western, we are performing the SDS phage. The gel pretreatment in case of southern, we have to do certain things like depurination, denaturation, and the neutralization. The blotting method that we are using in case of southern is capillary, in case of northern it is capillary, in case of western it is electric. The probes that we are using in case of southern is DNA, in case of northern is complementary DNA, in case of western it is primary and secondary antibodies. The detection method in case of these three types of blotting is almost similar. We are carrying out the autoradiography. And the function of southern is to identify the specific gene sequences. In case of northern, it is used to analyze the gene expression. In case of western, it is used to identify the protein expression and for the diagnosis of diseases, majorly focusing on the viruses. So this is what we studied today about the blotting techniques. So we have come to the conclusion of the first lecture. Don't forget to like the video, share and subscribe, and do drop down a feedback. What video do you want us to make next? Thank you.